Hi kids, it's time for praise and worship. So let's get up on our feet and we're gonna sing and dance for Jesus. So the first song is 我们是光明之子。Let's clap.
Save the music, let's end.
together we are going to talk to God. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for being our protector. Thank you for always helping us and protecting us. Now we are going to listen to our Bible story. Help us to focus and be attentive. In Jesus' name, all God's precious children say, Amen. Hi kids, we are going to play a game. My head is thinking of a word now. It's a really long and difficult word. It has 10 letters. So your job is to guess that word. So you need to put on your thinking caps. Are you ready to guess that word? Okay, the first hint to the first letter is this. What animal is this? This is a panda. Panda starts with the letter P. That's right. So the first letter of my word is P. Next one. What is this? It's long and purple. It's an eggplant. And what letter does the eggplant start with? The eggplant starts with the letter E. So you have P-E. The next one. What is this animal with two long ears? It's a rabbit. And what letter does the rabbit start with? It starts with the letter R. So you have P-E-R. Can you guess what my word is? Nope, not yet. So let's go on. Oh, this is a snake. And what letter does the snake start with? Starts with the letter S. That's right. Oh. 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 It's very heavy. What is this? It's an iron. And what letter does the iron start with? It starts with the letter I. I for iron. Ooh. Ooh, smelly. What's this? This is a shoe. And shoe starts with the letter S. So we have P-E-R-S-I-S. Persis. Can you guess what is it yet? Not yet? Okay, let's go on. Ooh, this one. Oh, it's very hard. This is a tortoise in its shell. What letter does tortoise start with? Tortoise starts with the letter T. T. Tortoise. T. And ooh, big, big elephant with big ears. What letter does elephant start with? It starts with the letter E. E. Elephant. E. That's right. And this one over here. Oh, it's really small but it's really sharp. This is a nail. What letter does nail starts with? It starts with the letter N. That's right. And the last letter. What is this? This is a tambourine. And what letter does the tambourine start with? Ta, ta. Tambourine. T. Now we have all the letters. P-E-R-S-I-S-T-E-N-T. And how do you read this really long word? It is persistent. Can you say it with me? Persistent. One more time. Persistent. What does persistent mean? Persistent means that you keep going and you never give up. You're persistent, you keep going and never give up. So in today's story, we are going to learn of a man who was persistent. So are you ready to listen to the story? If you're ready, I'll see you in a while. Okay, let's listen to our Bible story now. Once there was a man who was really persistent. He kept going and never gave up. This man is called Patrick. And Patrick lives in a little house like this. Now one day, Patrick's best friend came from a faraway land to visit Patrick. And he wanted to stay in Patrick's little house. And when Patrick saw his best friend, he was very happy. He wanted to cook a nice meal for his best friend. But when Patrick went back to his house, he realized that he had no more food. And it was 12 midnight already, and all the shops are closed. So Patrick couldn't go to the shops to buy food. And at 12 midnight, what do you think everybody is doing? They are sleeping. But Patrick, he really, really wants to cook a nice meal for his friend. So he decided to go to his neighbor's house to get food. So he went to his neighbor's house and he knocked on his neighbor's door. There was no sound from his neighbor's house. What do you think Patrick's neighbor is doing right now? He is sleeping. But Patrick was persistent. He kept going and never gave up. So he knocked on the door again. This time even louder. Now this time the knock woke Patrick's neighbor up. And the neighbor shouted, "Go away, Patrick! I am sleeping! I have no food for you!" Now, do you think Patrick will give up? No, Patrick is really persistent. He will keep going and never give up. So he carried on knocking on the door even louder this time. This time, the neighbor was really irritated. He woke up from his bed, went out of his house, and gave Patrick a basket of food. When Patrick saw the basket of food, he was really happy. So he brought the basket of food back and he cooked a nice meal for his best friend. Now children, this is a story that Jesus told. What do you think Jesus wants us to learn from this story? Jesus wants us to learn to pray persistently, just like how Patrick was persistent in knocking on the neighbor's door. And when Patrick knocked on the door persistently, did the neighbor answer the door? Yes, the neighbor answered the door. So when we pray persistently to God, God will surely answer. So let us learn to pray persistently, keep praying and never give up. Okay, so let us do our worksheets. Now, who is this man over here? It is Patrick. And what's Patrick doing? He's knocking on the door. Did he knock on the door one time? Or did he knock on the door many times? He knocked on the door many times. He was persistent. Because he was persistent, so his neighbor answered the door. Now, from this story, God wants to teach us how we should pray. So let's find out how we should pray by matching the correct key to the key on this door. Okay, let's look at this key. This key has one teeth over here, can you see? But this key has two teeth. So this key does not match this key. So no, we don't want this key. And what does this key say? It says never pray. Did God tell us to never pray? No, we should always pray. Okay, let's look at the other key, okay? This key has 1, 2, 3 teeth. And this key only has 2 teeth. So this is not the key. And what does this key say? It says pray half-heartedly. No, we should not pray half-heartedly. We should put in our best effort to pray. And the last key over here, this key has 2 teeth. And this key also has 2 teeth. So this key matches this key. So this is the key. So you have to color this key, alright? And what does this key say? It says, pray persistently. That's right. God teaches us that when we want something, we pray for it persistently. Then God will answer our prayers. activity. And for today's fun activity, we are going to do a really, really pretty craft like this. And to do this pretty craft, you need to have a lot of persistence. That means keep going and never give up. So first, you have to take out your plastic bag of art materials, okay? And then take out this black paper that looks like a window. Place it in front of you. And then take out the prayer hands. You're gonna stick the prayer hands in the middle of this black paper, okay? There are double-sided tape behind, so remove the double-sided tape. Okay, so you place it in the middle of your window, like this, okay? So next, you are going to paste the shiny paper onto the black window. So you're going to take out the Ziploc bag of shiny paper, and then take out your glue. Okay, so I am going to show you how to stick your shiny paper onto the black window. You will first start from the bottom corner. So you're going to apply some glue onto the bottom corner, like this. Apply as much glue as you can so that the shiny paper sticks really well. And you can choose any color you want. I want to start off with green. Okay, so you paste at the bottom. Can you see when I paste? I don't paste right at the edge. I leave some black space. Can you see over here? I leave some black space between each of the shiny paper. That will make your craft look really nice. Okay, the second one, I'm going to choose a pink triangle. So I'm going to put some glue on the black paper. And then I am going to paste it down. Remember to leave some black space between the shiny paper. Can you see the black space? Alright, okay, so I'm done with two. And there are many more to go. And that is why you need to have persistence doing this craft. And when you have persistence doing this craft, can produce a pretty craft like this. So remember, persistence is very important, especially when you're praying to God. Okay, children, let's do our memory verse now. Let's read it together. 1, 2, 3. Ask and it will be given to you, from the book of Matthew chapter 7 verse 7. So what does this verse mean? It means that when we need something, we need to ask for it, and we need to ask for it persistently. And when we do that, God will give it to us. Alright, so let's read it one more time. Ask and it will be given to you, from the book of Matthew chapter 7 verse 7. Now let's erase our first word, ask. Okay, let's erase the word ask. We need to ask God when we need something. Okay, we cannot just keep quiet and let God give it to us. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Ask and it will be given to you. Good job. Okay, I am gonna erase the word given now. Okay, when we ask for it, God will surely give it to us. Given. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Ask and it will be given to you. Well done. The next two words I'm going to erase are will be. Okay, God will definitely give it to us when we ask for it persistently. Will be, okay? 1, 2, 3. Ask and it will be given to you. Alright, the next two words. To you. God will give it to you. Alright? 1, 2, 3. Ask and it will be given to you. Well done. Now the last two words we have left. I am going to erase it all the way. Okay? Can you do it? This is and it. Us and it. Are you ready? This time really loud so your neighbors can hear you. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Us and it will be given to you from the book of Matthew chapter 7 verse 7. Well done, children. Okay, so let us put our hands together. We're going to close the eyes. We're going to talk to God. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for loving us and giving us what we need. When we need something, help us to remember to ask it for you and ask it persistently. And we know that. And we know that when we do it, you will give it to us because you love us very much. We love you, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name, all God's precious children say, Amen. So see you next week. Bye-bye.